Hello and welcome to this Ideas to Cycles video. This video is about manufacturing metal lugs for bicycle frames using additive manufacturing. The content presented here will be of interest to anyone studying the differences between various AM methods, or to someone looking to build a custom bicycle but not sure which process to go with. All of the bicycle concepts presented here are based on metal lugs with carbon fiber tubes bonded to them. In all cases, additive manufacturing is used to produce the metal lugs. So let's look at the three methods compared in this video. The first method is 3D printing wax patterns, making a mold using them and casting metal into the mold. The second case is 3D printing the mold directly and then casting. The third case uses direct metal printing. Let's start with the first case. Before I show the results, let's look at the typical process steps of a metal casting process. I will use this list as a basis for comparing the three methods with each other. It is therefore necessary to briefly go through the list here. It's important to understand the differences between the methods, and I will keep referring back to this list throughout the video. The first step is to do computer-aided design coupled with some simulations. The second step is to design the tooling that is going to be used. The third step is simulating the manufacturing process. In a traditional casting process, you would make a master mold used for serial production of patterns. Since we are now talking about bicycle prototypes, we will omit the fourth step completely and go directly to the fifth step, which is making patterns. When the patterns are made, they are combined into a pattern cluster, and a ceramic mold is built on top of the pattern cluster, which is step number 7. In step number 8, the wax is removed and the ceramic mold is sintered. When the mold is ready to be used, molten alloy is poured into the mold and allowed to solidify and cool down. After it has cooled, the mold can be broken and the parts can be extracted. Some post-machining is needed because the tolerances are too low for our application. I will now briefly show some of the process steps with the help of pictures to give you an idea of how the manufacturing process goes. First, we start with the computer-aided design. Here we have a 3D model of our bicycle frame. With the 3D geometry done, we can move on to making the wax patterns. Here are some 3D printed patterns that will be used for investment casting. The wax patterns are combined into a pattern cluster, like this. The pattern cluster is then used to build a ceramic mold. Here we are dipping the mold in a slurry and applying sand on top, layer by layer building up the mold. Then on to dewaxing and sintering. Sometimes the wax catches fire, so it's nice to have a low ash residue when sintering. When the mold is ready, we can move on to pouring our molten alloy. Here we are using a magnesium alloy, together with an inert shielding gas that prevents the ignition of the casting. Once the part has cooled down and solidified, we can move on to breaking the mold. It's done with a hammer and a pressure washer. The pressure washer will erode away the ceramic mold, leaving the ductile metal parts intact. Here's a picture of the finalized bicycle and a closer look at each of the joints. Then let's look at the second case using additive manufacturing to produce the mold directly. We immediately are able to remove some of the process steps. We no longer need to print the patterns and create the pattern cluster. There is no need for dewaxing or sintering either. Let's look at some of the process steps next. Once again, we start with computer-aided design. This time we did some topology optimization using the finite element method. We define boundary conditions, load cases, design space, and optimize for a property. In this case, we are maximizing stiffness for a given amount of material remaining. On the left, you see the initial state, and on the right, you see the resulting mass distribution after topology optimization. We then apply the load cases on the final geometry to verify that it is what we aim for. We need to design the mold, of course. Here is a picture showing the parting plane, mold block, and some runners and feeders. We then simulate the casting process. We can simulate melt flow, solidification, and get a prediction of porosity. This step is important to ensure that the mold is completely filled and the sections solidify in correct order. We then go on to make the molds. Here is a 3D printed sand mold. Three of the parts need a core, otherwise it's a simple two-part mold. Then lastly, post-machining. This part was cast using a metal matrix composite. It's an aluminium alloy matrix with silicon carbide reinforcement particles, and it's quite difficult to machine. However, we had to bore out the bearing surfaces for a correct interference fit. The finished bicycle with carbon tubes bonded to the lugs is shown here. And here's a closer look at the lugs themselves. Finally, let's look at the third process, that is 3D printing metal parts directly. Now only 5 steps remain when using the direct metal printing approach. As with all additive manufacturing processes, we need to have a 3D model. So we start off with computer-aided design. Here's the frame we want to produce. Once again, carbon fiber tubes bonded to metal lugs. We don't have molds to break, but the parts do need to be removed from the build plate. The lugs shown here are actually from another set, but it's showing what kind of support structure is being used, and you can get an idea of how difficult it is to remove. Here's the finished bicycle with carbon fiber tubes bonded to it. And here's a closer look at the lugs. So now you want to know, of course, which method is best. The wax patterns are the cheapest, but the process takes the longest. There are many steps involved and you need to wait between each step. Direct metal printing is the fastest, but it's also the most expensive. Printing the mold is somewhere in between these two. Of course, the exact costs depend on geometry, and remembering that time is money, the comparison becomes more complex. In general, we prefer the direct additive manufacturing process, simply because the amount of steps is low compared to the other methods. This means that there's less of a chance of failed steps, and product development iterations are faster in case there's a design error. Now have a look at our other videos describing the investment casting process in more detail. We also have a couple of videos describing the topology optimization steps in more detail. All right, thanks for watching.